नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, Srimahans, Mahans, Kotaris, Tanedars, sitting with us all over the world through Nityananda TV, Sadhana TV, and two-way video conferencing, having Nainadiksha. Cities sitting with us in two-way video conferencing, having Nainadiksha. Guadalupe, Rameshwaram, Houston, Kalahasti, Nityananda University, Los Angeles, Kuala Lumpur, Palani, Thiruvanmiyur, Chennai, Surrey, Canada, Nityananda, Nagaramo, Hyderabad, Ohio, Prayag, Oklahoma, Somanatham, Salem, Dhyanapeetam, San Jose, Madurai, Singapore, Singapuram, Toronto, Kailasam, Dhyanatma, High Point, North Carolina, Nyaneshwar, Nepal, Warrington, UK, Miami, and Nityananda Nagaramu, Hyderabad, Kathmandu, Nepal, Winston, Salem, North Carolina, Hyderabad, Gupta Kashi, London Kashi, Ohio, Ma Shivananda, Belgium, Hong Kong, Sirgadi, Tune Moon, Hong Kong, Vishveshwarananda, New York, Nityananda University, Paris, Nityananda University, Los Angeles, Dubai, Vaidyanatham, Brooklyn, New York. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. Today I wanted to expand on this one truth. Hridaya Guhya Tahara Vidya. In all of us, please listen, in all of us, there is a strong cognition which is spontaneous for us, which forms the core of our heart, core of our being. Hridaya Guhya, which is cherished in the cave of the heart. For some people, I am this body, is the Hridaya Guhya Tahara Vidya. They function, think, do everything with that understanding. I am this body from morning till night, painting and cleaning externally and internally takes the whole day. Internal washing, cleaning, filling, external washing, cleaning, painting takes whole day. Even the little remaining time they have, they will be working to get all this. Understand? All of us have Hridaya Guhya Tahara Vidya. In our heart cave, a natural understanding, a spontaneous flow of knowledge. Some people think mind, name and fame, the reward, joy. Joy which comes when others praise you. That is you. If that becomes your Hridaya Guhya Tahara Vidya, the spontaneous knowledge about life, then whole life you run behind that stupid Nobel Prize. And finally, you get rejected and dejected and you go on teaching how to live to people. You need to understand what actually your Hridaya Guhya, in the heart cave, you think as your spontaneous cognition about inner image, outer image, life image and others image. Spontaneously, what do you think? Understand? Spontaneously, what you understand? spontaneously what you carry. I wanted every one of you to know, spontaneously what you carry is what you brought from the past birth. That is what you brought from the past birth. My hrithaya vidya, hrithaya guhya tahara vidya. The spontaneous cognition, knowledge, I brought in my heart cave is completely aligned to all these four images. Completely aligned to all these four images. Aligned to all these four images. Listen. Completely aligned to all these four images. I may want to repeat this again and again till you listen. Listen. That was my spontaneous flow of life. What you feel inside you as you, what you declare outside you as you, what you want others to experience you as you, what you feel about others and the world. Aligning all these four to best and constantly, please listen, the life happening in you, every moment you feeling I exist is like energy. To whatever you want, you can infuse that life into it. If you constantly think, I have so much of SDHD, I can never be successful, more and more you associate yourself with that, that becomes alive. Understand? In the beginning you may not be able to change what happens outside, but you will be able to always change what happens inside. So decide, even for a few minutes, you will not empower, energize. The concept that you are a failure, you are struggling, you are... Few days before, one of my swami was telling, I complete and get out, again I fall back, and complete and get out, again I fall back. You want to enjoy this personality. You are enjoying this space. You want to empower this idea of I raise and fall, raise and fall, because you must be enjoying the effort, hard effort you are putting. Understand, hard work is nothing but ignorance. You don't have intelligence to do the smart work. You are stupid enough not to do the smart work. What you do is called hard work. And if you enjoy hard work, nobody is going to say no. But you are stupid. Why will you complete yourself and then come out again, fall into the same ditch and complete yourself and come out? Because you empower that cognition. I am struggling, sincere seeker. Because you set a standard to yourself long, long, long ago. At least I will be a good seeker. Whether I achieve it or not, who knows? I don't think I can achieve. That and all is not possible for me. But I'll be a good seeker. And maybe that is the way you will try to get others' attention. See, I am struggling and coming out. But stupid thing. Nobody is ready to listen to your struggle. Understand? How much ever you try to decorate your struggle, nobody is ready to listen to your struggle unless you win the game. Only when you win the game, your struggles are garlanded, respected, worshipped. Your struggles by itself has no respect. So decide to win the game now. See, every moment your life empowers some cognition. Either, see, all these different cognitions. I am struggling. I can't achieve it. I can achieve it. I have achieved it. All these are just various cognitions, various balloons. You can fill the gas in any balloon. Your life is the gas. You can fill the gas in any balloon. Why do you want to waste your gas into the stupid balloon? I am struggling. Complete it. Get rid of it. I have achieved. Fill the balloon of I have achieved. Then what is the qualifications of achieved, person who has achieved? Always be aligned. This aligning, I wanted to expand on this little deeper. Morning when you wake up, just ask yourself, an authentic person who lives Advaita, how he will wake up? He will just wake up like Mahadeva and bless the world. How he will shower himself, clean himself gracefully. What he will do next? Whatever I am doing, is it aligned to my identity which I want to build as my inner image, which I want to show as outer image, the other's image and life image, which I want to take the responsibility for? This aligning, the moment you decide, yes, this action has to be done if I want to have this outer image. After that, no conflict, no question of conflict, no question of contradiction, no question of anything else. No question of conflict, no question of contradiction, no question of anything else. In all of your life, what you want to build, clearly decide now and always align your actions to it. That is what is spiritual practice. In my case, I came with what I want, all these four clearly, and always my actions were aligned to it. That is why I claim born enlightened. Understand? The Hridaya Guhya Tahara Vidya was very clear. The spontaneous expression, the way you think, every moment you are thinking, let it be aligned to what you want to show you as you to the world. What do you want to feel you as you to you? What do you want others to feel you as you? What do you want to feel as world? Again and again and again align yourself to that authenticity. The best inner image you want to have, best outer image you want to have, best others image you want to have, best life image you want to have, How much ever you think it is difficult, it is achievable. Be very clear. The idea of your difficulty is nothing but your SDHD. See, the mirage water need not be drained for your car to go in the road. The summer time, noon, mid-noon, you will see the mirage water in the road. It literally looks like a large water body in the middle of the road. Do you need to bring big motor pumps, pipe, and drain the water for your car to drive? No. You just need to understand it is illusion and drive. Same way, your SDHD, you don't need to be struggling with it. You just need to know it is your SDHD and drive. I tell you, anything can be given up in the life. Anything can be lost. Not one thing. That is self-driving motivation. Just if that is maintained, everything is done. The high self-drive. In anything you take it up. The high self-drive is life. Not having the high self-drive is death, that's all. That's all is life. Whenever in your life you lived with high self-drive, you were alive. Whenever it was lost, you are dead. Whenever you had high self-drive in your life, you were alive. Don't remember the moments of money as important moments in your life. Don't remember moments you have been rewarded, awarded as the important moments of your life. Don't keep those stupid photographs of your graduation, your lottery winning in your house as your important moments of the life. No. When that stupid cap was put and that certificate was given in your hand, you became intelligent. Don't keep that as a memorable moments of your life in your house. Whenever you had a high self-drive, those moments are the most memorable moments of your life. Keep them as the memorable moments of your life in your house. I tell you, high self-drive. Don't keep that stupid marriage photograph, your graduation photograph, all that as the memorable moments of your life. Your first baby. You bought a new house, first house. All these as the memorable moments of your life. No, all this happens as an accident. The high self-inspired drive moments you had in your life, those moments, memories of those moments, achievements of those moments, it might have been as simple as you took the lawn mower and mowed your whole house, whole lawn, or you took the vacuum cleaner and cleaned your whole house. It can be as simple as those moments. Or you decided to hike the mountain and went on a hike. Or you decided to swim and swam for 2-3 hours. Or you decided to go for a long perpetual completion session and sat for 3-4 hours in the space of completion. It can be as simple as any one of these. High self-drive moments should be respected, celebrated, worshipped, remembered as the memorable moments of your life. All this, the first house you bought, the graduation certificate, your marriage, your first kid. All these can be social accidents. You say that social accident moments of my life. Keep them all in an archive in your house. Social accident moments of my life. But only when you were living in the high drive. It can even be in your office. Without bothering about what money is going to come or anything. You just sat for 10 days and finished a project. Those moments, high self-drive moments, get them as the memorable moments of your life. Get them as memorable moments of your life. And they are only memorable moments of your life. They are only memorable moments of your life. They only need to be repeated. Understand? The moments need to be repeated in your life is the high self-drive moments. Not for money, neither for reward, or for any other things. Just out of self-inspiration, the dharmic high drive moments you had in your life are the moments to be celebrated, experience to be cherished, inspiration to be kept alive, life to be recreated. Please understand, again and again and again, see how you can become more and more authentic to your best inner image, outer image, life image, others' image. Understand, any doubt you have, any idea you have, you cannot achieve that four, is SDHD. Self-doubt, self-hatred, self-denial. SDHD. Go on completing with those SDHDs. Go on completing with those SDHDs. Let the external situation not create SDHD in you, not encourage SDHD in you. Understand, the external situations should not be creating an SDHD in you. Constantly complete the SDHD and constantly align yourself to the declared identities, to the best identity. That is what I call Advaitic activism. Advaitic activism. This is what exactly I call Advaitic activism. Advaitic activism is my life. Advaitic activism is my message. I expect Advaitic activism to be your life. And Advaitic activism is our collective life. Understand, you need self-drive to complete SDHDs. No one can complete SDHDs for you. No one can complete. That is the only thing even Guru cannot do for you. Everything else Guru can do, and only Guru can do. But completing with SDHD, even Guru cannot do, only you can do it to yourself. That is the freedom you have. to live or leave SDHT. Just decide. Living with SDHT feels good or leaving the SDHT feels good. Living with SDHT feels good or leaving the SDHT feels good. Understand? Living with SDHT feels good or leaving the SDHT feels good. Completing with SDHT, only you can do it to yourself. Again and again and again, demanding authenticity from yourself. Again and again and again, asking for authenticity from yourself. I tell you, if you retain your self-driving inspiration, whether you are grihastha or sannyasi, doesn't matter, you will become enlightened. If you lose your self-drive, whether you are a grihastha or a sannyasi, be very clear, you will be a failure. It is SDHD that matters. If you complete SDHD, you achieve it. If you are suffering, struggling with it, your life becomes hell. It is SDHD that decides whether your life is going to have the self-drive, enlightenment or not. SDHD is like a cow dung. If that is dumped, even the diamond will be covered. Even the diamond will lose its shining if just ordinary cow dung is dumped on it. But even if 1,000 years the cow dung was on diamond, the moment you wash the cow dung, diamond will again shine in its original glory. Even if you are suffering, struggling with SDHD for 1,000,000 years, if you wash the SDHD now, your inner glory will stand up again. Understand? Come to the space of Advaitic activism. Come to the space of Advaitic activism. Come to the space of Advaitic activism. The more and more you align yourself, your declared inner image, best inner image, best outer image, best others image, best life image, the more and more you tune yourself to that, more and more you become authentic. The more and more you become authentic, the more and more you live enlightenment. You live Advaita.
I bless you all. Let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching and causing eternal bliss. Nityananda. Thank you.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 08027279999. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.